In this video, I want to show you how you can answer a typical iOS interview question. So here's the question I've picked. What's the difference between method overload and method override? When you need to answer that kind of question, it's always good to start with a little bit of context. You can see this as an introduction. It's a way to ease into the actual answer. Here, for instance, you can start by saying that it's no coincidence if overloading and overriding almost feel confusingly similar, and it's because these two concepts refer to two different flavors of a same more general concept called polymorphism. And at its core, polymorphism is about how a same symbol in code can refer to different things depending on the context in which it is used. So in order to answer the question, we actually need to discuss what kind of polymorphism do overloading and overriding actually implement. So now let's move on into the actual answer, and let's begin by talking about overloading. We can say that we overload a method when we define one or more additional methods with the same name, but with a different combination of arguments. And in Swift, overloading can happen in two different ways. It can happen either by explicitly defining a new implementation of a method for each combination of arguments, like in this example. Here we have two different implementations of a same method name, but we can see that each implementation has a different type for its argument, and so the compiler will take care of calling the correct method depending on the type of the argument we use at the call site. But this is not the only way to implement overloading in Swift, because overloading can also be achieved through generic arguments, also sometimes referred to as parameterized types. Here is an example of such an overload that relies on a generic argument, and in that instance, the compiler will take care of creating overloads that will match the actual type we use at the call site. And what's very important to highlight about overloading is that this form of polymorphism doesn't depend on runtime conditions and so can be entirely determined at compile time. And it's important to have this in mind because this means that the compiler will be able to optimize the code so that there is little to no overhead at runtime due to the fact that we have used overloading. Now let's move on to the second part of the answer and talk about overriding. Once again, it's a similar idea because we want a same method to have a different behavior depending on the context in which it is called. Except that this time, the actual behavior won't depend on the type of the arguments passed to the method, but rather on the actual type of the instance that the method will be called on. In Swift, method overriding is only possible when we use classes, and here's how it would typically look like. We have a first class A that implements a method, and then we introduce a second class B which inherits from class A, and this second class overrides the implementation of the method so as to provide a different behavior than the one that was implemented in the parent class. And what will happen is that when we call the method, the implementation that will be used will depend on the actual type of the instance on which we have called the method at runtime. So here's how it would look. You can see that even though the variable instance is statically typed to class A, the implementation that will be called will actually be the implementation of class B because the actual instance stored in the variable is of class B. But here it's important to note that unlike overloading, overriding does have a cost at runtime because the compiler won't be able to prematurely decide on the right method to call since it can depend on things that won't be known until runtime. Here's a typical example of such a situation. You can see that here the actual type of the instance is decided randomly at runtime, and so the compiler has no way at compile time to decide in advance which implementation should be called, which means that the compiler needs to create the code that will at runtime check the actual type of the instance and trigger the right method. And of course, this additional code will have a cost at runtime. Okay, now that we're done with the answer, it's always good to finish with a bit of a recap in order to sum up what was quite a lengthy answer. So here we can sum up our answer by saying that overloading is about providing different method implementations depending on the argument types used at compile time. And overriding is basically about the same thing, but this time depending on the actual instance type at runtime. And once you're done answering the question, it's always nice to quickly mention any extra knowledge you might have about the topic. For instance, here you could mention that because Swift supports subtyping, it's totally possible for a call site to have more than one potential method overload candidate that matches the types being used. And so, in order to decide which candidate overload should be used, Swift relies on a set of rules. For instance, Swift will always prefer an overload candidate with a concrete type over one with a generic type. Here's an example of how such a situation would look like. We have a first overload that expects the concrete type int. Then we have a second overload which uses a generic type that is constrained to implementing the protocol numeric. And if we try to call that method with a value that is statically typed as an integer, even though both overloads would be matching candidates according to the type of the value, Swift will prefer using the overload that expects a concrete type int over the overload that expects a generic type that conforms to the protocol numeric. And I think we can stop here. We've definitely delivered a pretty solid answer to that question. If you've enjoyed this video and you would like to see more examples of how to answer typical iOS interview questions, I've actually made an entire training course about it. You can check it out. The link is in the description, or you can just follow this QR code. That's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you for watching it, and see you next time.